friend who watched this all happen. She's live right now with that story. Kelly.
Good afternoon, Ben and Lourdes. A very tragic story. Family and friends are still trying to come to grips with exactly what happened overnight as they remember their loved one, 42-year-old Eric Smith. The devoted father of three was a family man, and he died doing what he loved last night. I'm told that he is a motorcycle enthusiast and an avid Bears fan.
The tragedy happened.
Oh, yeah. It's so much fun watching the Bears game. Cracking jokes, watching the Bears turn around and beat the Cowboys. I mean, it was a night of nothing but laughs.
But the evening took a tragic turn on the way home. Cassandra Hunt drove her SUV while her boyfriend rode his motorcycle down the Bishop Ford Freeway. Smith needed to stop for gas, so they slowed down and turned their hazard lights on.
I looked in my rearview mirror and I remember seeing his headlight, and I was like, okay, he's there. So now, and then I just heard a huge crash, and when I looked back, I didn't see him.
State troopers say a drunk driver hit Smith on Interstate 94 at 111th Street, throwing him off his motorcycle.
The car that allegedly hit him actually sped past me on my left side on three wheels.
The drunk driver didn't get far. Police arrested the 42-year-old man at 103rd and Stony Island. But Cassandra was left picking up the pieces of the crash.
There were just fragments of motorcycles, and I found him in the mud in the ditch. And I held him, and he kind of like let out a breath and sort of went limp.
Smith was taken to Roseland Hospital, but doctors couldn't save him. Family and friends of the Chosen Breed Motorcycle Club showed up to support each other during this trying time.
He was just an all-around great guy. I had so many friends and people that loved him because just his spirit was amazing. It's hard, but he was a great person. So it's better to have known him than not.
Smith leaves behind three kids, ages 21, 16, and 9. Family and friends tell me they are working to host some sort of memorial or candlelight vigil for him this weekend, but they're still sorting out those details. We'll be sure to share them as soon as we get them. Reporting live in Calumet Heights, I'm Kelly Davis, WGN News.